We have got to prove to the Lord that we can make a Zion here in our homes, which are to be temples and holy places to which we can repair when the judgments and the visitations come. We are not excused in the least, brethren and sisters, in establishing Zion here. We must establish it in Colorado City. We must establish it here and in Canada and wherever the saints are who have come out of the church and out of the world, or who have been trying to. Then we will be able to prove to the Lord that we are worthy and capable of going back and redeeming that center place, the city, the glorious city of Zion. We can have a glorious Zion in our homes. What beauty there is in a home where the Spirit of God fills all who dwell therein, when all are one, and we might be the Lord's, and that we might be able to be used.
I said, this goodly land upon which we live is the land which the land is Zion, and the land upon which we live.
We've broken this into three principal parts. First, what is Zion? Second, prophecies concerning Zion. And thirdly, the building of Zion.
What is Zion? We live in the greatest. We live in one of the greatest and most important times in the history of the earth so far, when God has set his hand to redeem his people and establish Zion and usher in the millennium. We are a vanguard, brothers and sisters, and if we would only realize the significance of this fact, we would be led to greater works and be more diligent in serving God and building up his kingdom and establishing his priesthood here in the earth. President Jeff.
I cannot think of a more glorious thing than for his people to be bound together, laboring for the redemption of Zion. We must first establish our Zion, the ones that we have immediate charge of, our families. Set in order our houses, our families, and all of our affairs, that the power of God may be exerted in our behalf through the priesthood. President Ruland T. Jeff.
A great deal has been said of late about the redemption of Zion and the prepared people for that purpose. In order to accomplish this, we must be one. Say, you are one, the Lord says, you are not mine. We must be one in our family. We must be one, brethren, as theirs is a holy priesthood with the key holder. This is the only way the channel will be kept clear for us to get and keep the Spirit of God.
And now, behold, if Zion do these things, she shall prosper and spread herself and become very glorious, very great, and very terrible. And the nations of the earth shall honor her and shall say, surely Zion is the city of our God, and surely Zion cannot fall. For God is there, and the nations, and the hand of the Lord is there, and he hath sworn by the power of his might to be her salvation and her high tower. Therefore, verily, thus saith the Lord, this is Zion, the pure in heart. Therefore, verily, let Zion rejoice while the wicked shall mourn.
Prophecies concerning Zion. And the day shall come that the earth shall rest, but before that day the heaven shall be darkened, and the veil of darkness shall cover the earth. And the heaven shall shake, and also the earth. And great tribulation shall be among the children of men, but my people will I preserve. And righteousness will I send down from heaven, and truth will I send forth out from the earth, to bear testimony of my only begotten, his resurrection from the dead, yea, and also the resurrection of all men. And righteousness and truth will I cast the sweet of the earth as with a flood, to gather out mine elect from the four quarters of the earth,
unto a place which I shall prepare, an holy city, that my people may gird up their loins and be looking forth for the time of my coming. For there shall be my tabernacle, and it shall be called Zion in the Jerusalem. And the Lord said unto Enoch, then shalt thou and all thy cities meet them there, and we will receive them into our bosom, and they will see us. And we will fall upon their necks, and they will fall upon our necks, and we will kiss each other. And there shall be mine abode, and it shall be Zion, which shall come forth out of all the creations which I have made. And for the space of 1,000 years, the earth shall rest. Romans 7, verse 61 through 64.
Yea, the word of the Lord concerning his church, established in the last days for the restoration of his people, as he has spoken by the mouth of his prophets, and for the gathering of his saints to stand upon Mount Zion, which shall be the city of New Jerusalem, which city shall be built and beginning at the temple lot, which is appointed by the finger of the Lord in the western boundaries of the state of Missouri, and dedicated by the hand of Joseph Smith Jr. and others with whom the Lord was well pleased.
Verily, this is the word of the Lord, that the city New Jerusalem shall be built by the gathering of the saints, beginning at this place, even the place of the temple, which temple shall be reared in this generation. For verily, this generation shall not all pass away, until an house shall be built unto the Lord, and a cloud shall rest upon it, which cloud shall be even the glory of the Lord, which shall fill the house. Section 84, verses 2 through 5.
In that day shall the branch of the Lord be beautiful and glorious, the fruit of the earth excellent and comely to them that are escaped of Israel. And it shall come to pass that they that are left in Zion and remain in Jerusalem shall be called holy, every one that is written among the living in Jerusalem. When the Lord shall have washed away the filth of the daughters of Zion, and shall have purged the blood of Jerusalem from the midst thereof, by the spirit of judgment and by the spirit of burning. And the Lord will create upon every dwelling place of Mount Zion and upon her assemblies a cloud and smoke by day, and the shining of a flaming fire by night. For upon all the glory of Zion shall be a defense, and there shall be a tabernacle for a shadow in the daytime from the heat, and for a place of refuge and a covert from storm and from rain. 2 Nephi chapter 14, verse 2 through 6.
And plagues shall go forth, and they shall not be taken from the earth, until I have completed my work, which shall be cut short in righteousness. Until all shall know me who remains, even from the least unto the greatest, and shall be filled with the knowledge of the Lord, and shall see eye to eye, and shall lift up their voice, and with the voice together sing this new song. This song is of the prophet Joseph, and one that would be sung by that prepared people after the redemption of Zion. So it will be the song of the morning. Saying, the Lord hath brought again Zion. The Lord hath redeemed his people Israel, according to the election of grace which was brought to pass by the faith and covenant of their fathers. The Lord hath redeemed his people, and Satan is bound, and tongue is no longer. The Lord hath gathered all things in one. The Lord hath brought down heaven Zion from above. The Lord hath brought up Zion from beneath. The earth hath travailed and brought forth her strength, and truth is established in her bowels. And the heavens have smiled upon her, and she is clothed with the glory of her God, for he stands in the midst of his people. Glory and honor and power and might she ascribed to our God, for he is full of mercy, justice, grace, and truth, and peace, forever and ever. Amen.
The building of Zion. In order for us to redeem Zion, if this may help us, we must first have Zion in our hearts, create Zion in our families. Zion is not only a place, but the whole of America is Zion. The center place is Jackson County, and all other places will be stakes of Zion. This is the place. But Zion is also a condition of the heart, and of the mind, of the spirit. Until we have Zion in our hearts, the Zion of the true and the faithful, the Zion of our God, with the pure love of Christ, charity, with knowledge, perfect faith, with justice and mercy and judgment and truth. Until we are filled with these, which are the Holy Ghost, and become one, we cannot go there and accomplish that great objective of the last days, of the last dispensation of the fullness of times, which has fully come. President Jeff.
And Zion cannot be built up unless it is by the principles of the law of the celestial kingdom. Otherwise, I cannot receive it unto myself. Doctrine and Covenants, section 105, verse 5.
These are few excerpts of President Jeff's quoting Brigham Young. This is in his quote book. We are going to have to make Zion here, where we are, before we are going to be able to go back and redeem Zion, the center place, the New Jerusalem, the holy city wherein will be the great temple to our God. Brigham Young was strong on this matter. He said, "You hear brethren talk of coming to Zion to enjoy the blessings of this land, but do you not see that it is the short-sightedness of men which causes their disappointment when they arrive here? They gather here with the spirit of Zion resting upon them and expecting to find Zion in its glory, whereas their own doctrine should teach them that they are coming here to make Zion. We can make Zion or we can make Babylon just as we please. We can make just what we please of this place. The people can make Zion. They can make a heaven within themselves. When people gather here, they should come with the determination to make Zion within themselves, with the resolution that I will carry myself full of the spirit of Zion." President Jeff says, "The spirit of God, wherever I go, and this is the way in which I will control evil spirits. For I mean that my spirit shall have control over evil." President Jeff says, "The Holy Ghost should have control of our spirits in order to control evil. And do you not see that such a course will make Zion? This American continent will be Zion, for it is so spoken of by the prophets. Jerusalem will be rebuilt and will be the place of gathering, and the tribe of Judah will gather there. But this continent of America is the land of Zion."